Today, our class is Microsoft Security Baseline and Templates. Nowadays, every IT company and organization getting some threats. So every company is concentrated on providing more secure on customer data and company data also. For example, banking sector. Banking sector is always concentrated on provide secure about customer details. Means how much balance is available, what is the customer ID, what is the password. They always concentrate on customer account or customer details in secure mode. Again, for example, e-market. So in this, for example, Flipkart, Amazon, eBay, in e-shopping, in this they always concentrate on that web applications. For example, Flipkart, they always concentrate on secure on that web application. For example, if any another person is creating same duplication, that time customer is using that application and is logging, that time he lost some money. And so here bank is concentrate on customer personal details, and here this e-market, e-shopping, it is concentrate on web application. Another one is the hospital. For example, hospitals is always concentrate on patient details. What is the present patient situation? What are the what is the personal details of the patient, and what is the disease? He always concentrate on the patient personal data. So this all companies is concentrate on keep the customer details and web application in secure mode. So this security purpose, they follow some security settings. Means this all companies receiving some threats. So he always concentrate on keep all these applications and this customer details in secure mode. Third purpose, this Microsoft company is maintaining Microsoft security baseline. Sir, what is the Microsoft security baseline? Sir, Microsoft security baseline, let's see here. Simple definition. What is the security baseline? Security baseline means here. Here. Group of Microsoft recommended configuration means here, what is the security baseline? Security baseline, simple definition is group of Microsoft recommended configuration settings. This configuration settings is called security baseline. Security baseline. Okay. So, who's recommended this configuration settings? Means here, this settings is recommended by all these settings are the settings this setting is feedback of Microsoft security engineer team or product group. Our customer. Actually, here this Microsoft is developing one application, for example, web application or client-related application. So, when that client is using that application, that time he is getting some threats. So, that time immediately that person is forward this information to Microsoft Service Center. Immediately that Service Center is checking these details and they are modifying that application. Means here, this application is allowing threats. Where is the mistake? How to we recover that? Immediately is concentrate on that and immediately he is releasing one patch. When we are installing patch, that time this problem is rectified. So here, what is the meaning of security baseline? Means it is the Microsoft recommended configuration settings. Okay, that configuration settings recommended by Microsoft security engineer team or that product group or customer. Means here these three, in this anyone is recommended to the Microsoft company, that is the Microsoft company is modifying that product. And here what is the advantage of this? For example, if you are allowing this Microsoft security engineer team to our company, or we are allowed to access our application to this Microsoft security engineering team, that then that team is giving some useful tips to how to maintain this application. So that time it is very useful to us. That is the main advantage. This security baseline only available in Microsoft product. Now it is available in Windows 10 and Microsoft this Windows Server 2012 or 2016. This application is available. So this is a security baseline. Security baseline means it is the group of Microsoft recommended configuration settings. And this configuration settings is the feedback of Microsoft security engineering team. Means this security engineering team is giving some feedback. Depending on that feedback, this Microsoft is doing some settings. And it is also feedback of product group and it is also feedback of customer. What is the template? Templates means that template means that template. Template is a text file. It is like settings. Means what is the template? Template is a text file. It is describes settings. Means which type of settings we are doing. That all settings is there are. Mentioned in this text file. Template means it is a text file. It is described settings. So here security baseline and template. This is a small topic. Now. What are the templates? For example, now here one is registry setting. So these are the examples of templates: registry settings, system permissions, and log settings. Here, this security baseline and templates is one small topic. After completing this, we are discussing about remaining topics. What are that computer hardware? We are not completing that. We are discussing the topic here. Template. Template means registry settings, system permissions, and log settings. So here. Now, how to implement this settings? How to? What is? Which one is the easy way to implement this settings? So here, how to implement this templates? Template implement purpose. General way is group calls. Group policy is the easy way to implement this templates. Means here, when we are installing DNS, after we are maintaining groups. In this, we are using this group policy to implement this templates. It is the easy way to implement these templates. Why we are using these templates and why we are discussing about this line is we try to protect our applications, our system from threats. That purpose we are using Windows security baseline and templates. So here, this feature is available only in Windows product. Now this feature is available in Windows 10 operating system and Windows Server operating system. Windows Server 2012 and Windows Server 2008 and Windows Server 2016, this feature is available. So here, this security baseline, this is a recommendation of configuration of settings for security purpose. So this one is more for the. So here, now we are understanding what is the Microsoft security baseline. Security baseline, it is a group of Microsoft recommended configuration settings. And this settings is the feedback. This settings is feedback of Microsoft security engineers. Means this settings is recommended by Microsoft security engineers or user or group persons. Means a product group. The product group sometimes it is means when it is releasing one application. That time some clients is using that application. In this, if they are getting any trouble, that time they are informed to this Microsoft. Immediately he is checking and it is rectifying that problem. And immediately it is releasing one patch file to all clients. This is the one way. Another way is after completing when it is releasing, after again this, if any client is sent complaint to this Microsoft Service Center, that time immediately that security engineer is checking where is the problem. So immediately that security person checking, that engineer is checking and they are rectifying and modifying, immediately they are releasing patch file. This is the Microsoft security baseline. And the template, what is the template? Template is a text file. It is described that configuration settings and how to implement that templates. We are implementing that templates by using group calls. This is one small topic today. Now, remaining topic is magnetic storage device. this magnetic storage device. In this example, please, first one is tape drive. Second one is floppy drive. And third one is hard disk. Hard disk. In this floppy drive is outdated, and this tape drive only using in some areas. And present we are using only hard disk drive. This is magnetic storage device. Means this hard disk is store data magnetically on platter. Platter is the one part of in hard disk. And here hard disk drive. In older days, this hard disk is available with IDE connector. Hard disk drive is available with IDE connector. IDE means we are discussing in next class. IDE means integrated drive electronics. The company is introduced to this connector, IDE connector. And in older days, this hard disk available with capacity. That capacity is 1 GB and 2 GB and 4 GB and 8 GB, 10 GB, 20 GB, 40, 60, 90, 120, 250, 320, and 500. And 1 TB and 2 TB. Present in desktop computers, we are using either 500 GB or 1 TB or 2 TB. But in older days, this hard disk capacity is available 1 GB, 2 GB, 4 GB, 8 GB, 10 GB, 20 GB, 40 GB, 60 GB, 80 GB, 120 GB, 250, 320, 500, 1 TB, 2 TB. But presently in our machines, we are using 500 GB or 1 TB or 2 TB. And in personal computer side, this hard disk is available with 5400 RPM and 7200 RPM. In older days, hard disk is available with 5400 RPM rotations per minute. But present hard disk is available with 7200 RPM. This too for desktop personal computer. In server hard disk RPM is 10,000 RPM. RPM and another one is 15,000 RPM. So in these two speeds. It is available. Rotations per means more rotations means data transfer speed also more. But in present in personal computer, that data transfer speed, this is the disk rotation means rotations per minute. One is the older days 5400, now 7200. And in this data transfer speed, generally here 100 Mbps, megabytes per second to 200 megabytes per second. In this 200 megabytes per second. This is the now present hard disk speed. Depending on this RPM, 100 to 200. Megabytes per second. This is the hard disk speed. And in this hard disk, new technology is coming. New technology hard disk is coming. That is called SSD, solid state drive. So in normal hard disk have mechanical parts, means spindle motor, plotter, actuator, and read write head. Means spindle motor is used to rotate that disk, and actuator is moving that read write head. Means mechanical parts is available. But in solid state drive, in this total memory chips, in this no mechanical parts, no mechanical parts, and it is. Advantage of solid state drive is, first one is lightweight. And second one is high speed data transfer. Data transfer speed is high. Data transfer speed. These two are the more advantages. Means compared to normal hard disk, the solid state drive is very lightweight, and data transfer speed is very high, and efficiency is high. Means durability is more. So here, this is the advantage. Means lightweight, data transfer speed is high, and efficiency is high. Means now compared to normal hard disk, the solid state drive data transfer speed is 10 times is faster. Compared to normal hard disk, and price. This normal hard disk drive, 1 TB. Price approximately, for example, 4,200 rupees, and solid state drive 1 TB, price approximately 22,000 rupees. Means compared to normal hard disk, means normal hard disk size is 1 TB and solid state drive also 1 TB, and here price is normal hard disk price is 4,200 and solid state drive cost is 22,000. Means this price is vary depending on the company. 2 or 3% is vary. And here advantages, solid state drive advantage is high speed and lightweight, efficiency means durability is more. This is the main advantage nowadays. In high-end laptops nowadays using solid state drive. Reason is it is high speed, means data transfer speed is more compared to normal hard disk, and lightweight, and efficiency means durability is more. Next, BIOS. Basic input output system. BIOS full form is basic input output system. In this BIOS, means what is the function of BIOS? Actually, BIOS is a one memory chip. So in this chip, we are loading some program. Generally, this program is called as a firmware. So here, the firmware is called BIOS program. So what is the main function of BIOS? BIOS means here BIOS main function is, first one is, it is update date and time. It is update date and time. And second one is Second one is post-operation. Post-operation means, you know, date and time. So this BIOS is updating date and time. That purpose, this BIOS IC wants continuous power supply. If system is on condition or off condition, that time this IC means this memory chip wants continuous power supply. That continuous supply purpose, we are providing 3 volts battery. 3 volts battery, generally are called CMOS battery. One button cell, it is providing 3 volts to this BIOS IC. That time only this BIOS IC maintaining date and time. If battery is weak, that time it is not maintaining proper time and date. If any machine is or any computer is showing wrong time, that time we are suspecting battery is weak. And second one is the post operation. Post means power on self test. Every time we are switch on this computer, that time first in this total computer, first this BIOS IC is activating post operation, means power on self test. Means here, when computer is on, immediately it is checking every connector and every port on motherboard. Means, for example, we are connecting some devices on SATA and ID and PCI, that time it is checking in ID port any device is connecting or not. If any device is connecting, what is the status, means it is working condition or not, what is the capacity of that one. And if you are connecting any device in SATA, it is checking that ports also. If you are connecting any device on PCI slots, it is checking that PCI slots also. Which type of card is connecting in PCI slots? Now it is working condition or not. What is the specifications of that one? Now if you are connecting any hard disk in SATA, immediately it is checking that hard disk is working or not. What is the capacity of that hard disk? And which company is manufacturing that hard disk? Every details it is collecting and it is saved. And after completing this post operation, means if you are connecting any pen drive in USB, or if you are connecting any printer into USB, or if you are connecting keyboard or mouse, it is checking every port and connector. And here, after completing checking each port and connector, after next is the booting. Next option is the booting. Means here, what is the main function of BIOS? Means it is updating date and time. Next one is the post operation. Post means power on self test. Power on self test means every time switch on computer, first computer is performing post operation. Power on self test means it is checking every port and connector on motherboard. If any device is connecting, that device's information it is collecting. After completing this, system is booting. Now we are discussing this personal computer by using one diagram. BIOS main functions is two. One is the it is update time and date. Second one is the post operation. Now we discuss this computer hardware by using one personal computer diagram. this is crosshair. This is generally we are called north bridge and this is called south bridge. Technical name of north bridge is graphics memory controlling hub, and technical name of this south bridge is input output controlling hub. These two generally is called as the chipset, or technically these two is called as co-process. This is the process. These two are called co-process. Here, this graphics memory controlling hub is controlling this RAM slots, PCI slot, and VGA port or HDMI port. Means here, this north bit is controlling RAM slot, PCI slot, and VGA slot. Except these three slots, this port and these two slots, remaining all are under control of south bridge. Means PCI slot and IDE, SATA, power on off, and here LAN port, audio jacks, USB, parallel port, serial port, TST port, all are under control of input output controlling hub. Now here, when we switch on this power switch, when we are press power switch, the time this south bridge is activating remaining all sections. When we are press this power on button, it is send power on signal to SMPS. SMPS is on and it is providing power supply to remaining all sections. When power is coming to this motherboard, immediately BIOS is activating and it is performed post operation. After completing post operation, if you are connecting one hard disk, primary hard disk to this SATA port, so now this operating system, generally we are saving in hard disk. It is a secondary storage device and RAM is a primary storage device. Here, when after completing post operation, this OS, generally this OS is saved in hard disk. After completing post operation, this OS is loading from this hard disk to RAM. Means here, when this OS is loading from hard disk to RAM, it is called booting. When this OS is loading from hard disk to RAM, that time your machine is ready. So in this, what is the process? First process is post operation. Post operation means power on self test. When power supply is coming, immediately BIOS IC is activating and it is checking PCI slot, IDE slot, SATA, and LAN, audio, USB, parallel port, serial port, and TST port. It is checking PCI slot, RAM slot, everything it is checking. For example, if any device is connecting to SATA ports, that time what is the nature of that device? Now it is working condition or not? What is the manufacturing company? Every details is connecting. If you are connecting any printer to USB, or if you are connecting any pen drive to USB, then it is also collecting that information. After completing this total, this ports and connector checking, next booting operation is start. Booting means operating system is loading from hard disk to RAM. It is called booting. When this loading process is completed, that is your machine is ready. So here, now in this graphics memory controlling hub, means this north bridge is organizing graphics related data. If any video related data is coming, that time this north bridge is organizing that data, graphics memory controlling hub. And here this PCI slot also connecting to this north bridge. Means if you are connecting any graphics card, that time it is directly communicating with this north bridge. And here VGA port or HDMI port or DVI port. This is all ports is connecting to this graphics memory controlling hub. Means video related total that ports or connectors is connecting to this graphics memory controlling hub. And except RAM slot, PCI slot, VGA port, remaining all is under control of this south bridge. Means input output controlling hub. Here, this is the personal computer internal diagram. Now, what is completed? Next RAM. Random access memory. Actually, this RAM is two types. One is the static RAM. One is the static RAM, another one is the dynamic RAM. Random access memory. This RAM is two types, static RAM and dynamic RAM. What is the function of RAM? RAM is the primary storage device or in computer. It is the volatile. If power is failure, internal total data is erased. At this time, two types, static RAM and dynamic RAM. First, we are discussing static RAM. In static RAM, one bit either 0 or 1. Stored in 4 transistors. Means, if we want store one bit in RAM, so that bit is storing purpose, it is using 4 transistors. And this static RAM is high speed RAM. High speed RAM. And here, if we want 1 GB RAM, that time you calculate that number of that bits multiply 4 transistors. So we are implementing that much of transistors. If we want to implement that much of transistors, that purpose means manufacturing cost is more. Compared to dynamic RAM, this static RAM cost is very high. Reason is, in this, it is stored one bit by using 4 transistors. So if we implementing that 4 transistor for one big purpose, so that purpose, it is manufacturing cost is very high. And compared to dynamic RAM, this static RAM is high speed. That is the reason nowadays this static RAM is used in servers, this static RAM is used in mobile phones, this static RAM is used in personal gadgets. Reason is, this is a high speed RAM. And nowadays we are not using this static RAM in laptops and desktops. What is the reason? Means this RAM cost is very high compared to dynamic RAM. This RAM only used in servers, high-end servers and mobile phones and personal gadgets. Using this RAM. And next one is the dynamic RAM. Dynamic RAM. In this dynamic RAM, one bit, either 0 or 1, stored in one transistor. Previously, in static RAM, one bit is stored in 4 transistors, but here one bit is stored one transistor. Means this transistor related have one capacitor. That capacitor is storing this 0 or 1. This is the difference between static RAM and dynamic RAM. In static RAM, that bit is stored directly in transistors, but in dynamic RAM, that bit is stored this transistor related capacitor. Every transistor have connected to one capacitor. That capacitor storing this either 0 or 1. And here, dynamic RAM
Speed is slow. Speed is low and cost also cheap. Cost also low. These are the advantage. This is the cost is low is the advantage. Speed is low is the disadvantage. But compared to this static RAM, this dynamic RAM cost is very cheap. That is the reason nowadays we are using this RAM in desktop computers and laptop computers. And this dynamic RAM is different types. In this, first one is DDR1, and second one is DDR2, and third one is DDR3, and fourth one is DDR4. Now present we are using DDR4 RAM. First one is DDR1 RAM, second one is DDR2, and third one is DDR3. DDR1, this RAM maximum capacity is 1 GB. This DDR2 maximum capacity is 2 GB. And this DDR3 maximum capacity is 16 GB. And this DDR4 RAM maximum capacity is 32 GB. DDR1 RAM, this RAM, one RAM is maximum capacity is 1 GB. DDR2, this DDR2 RAM maximum capacity is 2 GB, and this DDR3, one RAM maximum capacity is 16 GB. DDR4, one RAM maximum capacity is 32 GB. And here, compared to DDR1, DDR2, DDR3, DDR4, here DDR1, this RAM data transfer speed generally are called FSB. This DDR1 generally FSB is 400, and DDR2 maximum FSB is 800, and DDR3 maximum FSB is 2200, and DDR4 maximum FSB is 3600 FSB. What is the meaning of FSB? Means front serial bus. What is the FSB? Means why we are using FSB? Means for example, this is the motherboard. In this motherboard, this is the processor and this is the north bit. For example, this is the south bit, and you have RAM tanks. Now, from this RAM slot to this north bit, connecting some tracks. Now, data transferred from this north bit to RAM, RAM to north bit. That purpose we are using this tracks. What is the maximum data transfer speed of this tracks is called FSB, front serial bus. Depending on that motherboard, this FSB is varied. Means here, cheap cost companies, that FSB is very low. If you buy mid-range and high-range, that FSB is very high. Means here, what is the meaning of FSB? Means front serial bus. Means here, this RAM slot to this NOT bits are collecting some trucks. What is the maximum data transfer speed of these trucks is called FSB. For example, your motherboard FSB is 800. So that is compulsory. Means this is a DDR2 supporting motherboard. That time you purchase DDR2 800 RAM. Actually, this DDR2 RAM is available in 667 FSB and 800 FSB. So in these two different models is available. For example, your motherboard FSB is 800, that time compulsory you
purchase DDR2 RAM with 800 SSD. That time only your computer performance is increasing. And if you are purchasing your motherboard SSD is 800, but if you are purchasing DDR2 RAM with 67, that time your system speed is performance is slow. So compulsory when you are purchasing RAM, so before that come you find what is the motherboard FSD. So depending on that motherboard FSD, you buy that related RAM. Generally you observe if you have purchased any branded PC, in branded PC they are using 1 GB or 2 GB RAM. If you are assembled any same configuration computer, in this you are using 2 GB or 4 GB RAM. Means in assembled machine have high capacity RAM, means more capacity, but in branded machine have only 1 GB or 2 GB RAM. But compared to these two machines performance, branded machine performance is high compared to assembled machine. What is the reason? Means when then companies designing that PC, that time that company engineer perfectly matching motherboard FSD to RAM FSD. But nowadays hardware technician assembling on computer, that is simply that person going to shop and it is asking, I want to run DDR2 2 GB RAM. Simply that person is asking, but that person is not mentioned FSD. What is the FSD? If you simply ask to that vendor, means that shop, in shop, that time if you asking I want DDR2 RAM, that time that person is giving DDR2 RAM 2 GB RAM with 667. So that time means compared to 667, 800 FSD RAM cost is more. Both are 2 GB capacity, but 667 means here this is the data transfer speed, and 800 this is also data transfer speed. Both are 2 GB capacity, but here 2 GB RAM with 800 FSD, this RAM cost is high compared to 667. So that time if you want ask any 2 GB RAM, DDR2 2 GB RAM, immediately that shop person is giving 2 GB with 667, means this RAM cost is cheap. So that is the reason. Compared to branded machine, assembly machine performance is slow. Means this hardware technician is not matching motherboard FSD and RAM FSD. If you match this RAM FSD and motherboard FSD, then your machine performance is equal to branded machine. And here, now we are discussing FSD, front serial bus. But what is the actual data transfer speed? Data transfer speed generally we are calculating in megahertz, or megahertz. And so here